I put myself in NCAA football at a 45 overall, and I play for Northern Kentucky, my old college, but now I'm headed into my junior year, and between earning the starting job last season and also performing exceptionally well during practices after the training results boost, my player is up to a 93 overall, and my throw power is maxed out. Now, I saw a lot of comments on the last episode saying I needed to upgrade my awareness, because apparently my receivers won't drop it as much if I do, so we're gonna try to do that this season, and there's been some crazy upgrades available, but I can't afford them. That would have helped me achieve one of my two goals in my junior season, which is become a 99 overall, and the other is win the MAC conference, which could actually happen with these preseason projections. Due to hiring some new coordinators, our overall jumped up to an 86, and it might not be the highest overall in the conference, but it sure is close. We're just gonna get warmed up in this practice run with a touchdown, and then after we do that, I'm gonna hop into our first game of the season against Cincinnati. With one rep left, you'll see that I've gotten us over 10,000 total XP, so I'd say it went pretty well, as we just found Calvin Gibbs and he came away with it, so I'm curious if there's any good upgrades available. And I thought you were on fire or that blue and orange would be perfect, but it's only a one game boost. We're gonna save up our points and hop into this one, where playing against the Bearcats is a pretty big deal because they're just 10 minutes away from our college across the Ohio River, and I've already been able to find junior tight end Evan Carter Jr. for a nice game. One thing I'm gonna try to do more this season is take my check down since you all told me to, but because I did, this drive has stalled out and the halfback draw doesn't work. Our defense would get us the ball back pretty quickly though, and there's not many people open, so now we find ourselves on a 2nd and 10, where I am just gonna have to try and escape the pocket, and that's not happening. I'm trying to be very careful with my reads because I don't want to throw many interceptions this year, but so far what I've been doing hasn't worked, so maybe I need to start forcing it deeper down the field. Here on 2nd and inches, we're going to let Malachi Harris take this jet sweep where he is going to get us the first, and Daylon Maurice is going to be on the end of this wide receiver screen, but he doesn't get much. My hope is during the offseason he was able to fix his drop issue. I'm about to take a sack, and with play calling like this, we're about to have our third drive stalled out, which is not good. It was a pretty rough first quarter, but maybe we can open up the second in the best of ways, because I wanted to take that up the seam and I was not able to do so, but we're going to go with the deep post, and that is brought in by Daylon Maurice. I'm telling you all, whenever I start taking those deep passes, I play 10 times better, and that's a touchdown. So things are looking solid so far, but Cincinnati would respond back by getting onto the board for the first time, and that's going to be brought in. Now we're going to have a read option play where I get to keep it on the ground, but I'm still not the quickest, so I don't get much. And here on 3rd and 3, it's a halfback draw, but it is not going to go for the first. I should be happy that we're being aggressive going for it here, but it's not going to be in my hands, and Jace Dunn the second still picked it up. If we could just finish this drive off to end the first half, we would be in a great position. I'm going to find our tight end over the middle, but I think no matter what, we're going to give Cincinnati a ton of time to respond, and for whatever reason, my head coach keeps calling timeouts, but it's all good. We should have Evan Carter Jr. here, and with our tight end bringing it in, it is 14-3. Our defense would get a stop as well, so Northern Kentucky could be pretty good this season, but if I turn the ball over like that, maybe not, and I always make one bad read a game. Up to that point, I was playing almost perfectly, so I am pretty upset with myself. Now they're getting in pressure, and I'm gonna get it to Daylon, but he drops the pass, and I am terrified of taking this route on this play after I threw an interception there. Heisman mode always finds a way to humble you when you start doing really well, and Cincinnati opened up the third quarter by scoring a touchdown, so now we find ourselves trailing by 3 to the Bearcats. It's my fault that they were able to get back into it, so now I have to lead us down this field, and here on 2nd and 12, it looks like they are not going to bite down at the drag, so we're just going to take it. I really need to get some more coach trust though, so I can change up the play call whenever I don't like it, because now it's 4th and 1. We have to hand this off, and thankfully Calvin Gibbs is able to pick it up. I was not sure if our offensive line was actually going to hold there, but they must have improved a decent bit during the offseason, and the backup running back goes nowhere. This 3rd and 2 play call also isn't the best, but it did end up working, so the drive has continued to stay alive, and if this is man-to-man coverage, none of these routes are going to be open, so I'm just going to have to take off and do it all myself. We are closing in on reaching the end zone. I can't make any stupid reads in this situation though, so I'm gonna take off, and are you kidding me? I just lost the football, and if we don't get a stop on 3rd and 12, we're in trouble. But thankfully our defense did, so we are not out of it yet, and we just need one solid drive with a game-winning touchdown to end this game and get the win. It would be a huge result for Northern Kentucky since we weren't expected to come out on top of this one. I made a great throw on the run over to Calvin Gibbs, and I'm starting to want to escape the pocket quicker because I'm not sure how long our offensive line can hold for, but once again Daylon Maurice is gonna let me down. And on 3rd and 11, I'm hoping for man-to-man coverage where Malachi Harris brings it in. How our season starts all comes down to this drive, and the only reason we're even in this situation is because I put us here. I didn't have a good half, so I was hoping for a better play call on 3rd and 5. The halfback screen might not get it for us, and it's not going to. This is literally it. Here on 4th down, we're gonna take our hitch and we pick it up, but I was terrified of doing that there, and they get the instant sack. That's gonna make it 2nd and 17. There wasn't much I could do about it, but we're gonna get a lot of it back, and I'm hoping we can hit Malachi Harris up the seam where he's going to break the press and take it into the end zone. Now it is simply on our defense to hold the Bearcats. But with that completion, they've already gotten to the 40-yard line, and this is going to take them to midfield. They still have all three of their timeouts as well, so I'm afraid we're in a lot of trouble. That's going to be caught by Jackson, and we need them to score super quick because they're definitely already in field goal range. It's unfortunate, but now they're just being smart, trying to run out the rest of the clock, and they wouldn't get the two-point conversion, but there's only 13 seconds on the clock. I'm going to use my 99 throw power to go deep, and Malachi Harris catches it. We have one final shot at reaching the end zone, and I just have to hope for the best here. We're going to go over to our tight end, and that is going to be picked off. We are not going to get the win at Cincinnati, and our fans are not happy about it, but I think we proved that we can put up a good fight with every team in the MAC this season, and my stat line looks really good until you see it from this perspective where the two interceptions really sticks out. Now, before we take on our in-state rivals and my favorite team, I think it's important that I try to get myself some more coach trust. So that's what I'm going to do here in practice, which is out in the rain, and I just got to complete it to Dalen Maurice. However, things would not go as well as I was hoping they would, and because of an interception I threw, I gained almost no coach trust. I did get us up to 14,000 XP though, and I'm just waiting for some better skill upgrades because I don't think either of those are worth it. It's time to play against my favorite team for the first time on the road at Kroger Field versus the Wildcats, where I'm completing that pass, but they've already scored a touchdown and then missed the extra point because of the weather, so this could be a long game. And on 2nd and 10, they just want me to hand it off to Calvin Gibbs, who picks up the first. Now that he's a junior, he is starting to get a little bit better, so that's a good sign of what's to come in the future. Our corner route didn't get open on this play, and I waited too long to try and roll out, so we have to pick this up, and we don't. Fortunately, our defense would hold the Wildcats, so we have it back down by 6, and this first quarter's already flown by, where we have to figure out a way to pick up this 3rd and 11, and that window is gonna work. I wasn't sure if Dalen Maurice would hold on to that ball or not, but I'm very glad he did, and Evan Carter Jr. has come away with this one. So all of a sudden, we find ourselves down on the Wildcats 25-yard line, and I just have to make the smart read. I get very nervous whenever I can sense that they're sending pressure, but I had plenty of time back there. And now my hope is that we're able to reach the end zone if our C route gets open, and it does, but it's dropped. Dalen Maurice is going to drive me crazy, and nobody got open versus their man-to-man coverage, so I had to take it on the ground, but it worked. And using my legs, we're going to take a one-point lead on Kentucky. It wouldn't last as they responded back, but I'm just happy that we're able to compete with my Wildcats, and I think that's a good sign that we're going to do very well in MAC conference play. I'm going to try to bomb them deep here, and that's a great throw. Dalen Maurice actually caught the ball, which I was not expecting, but they have scored again, leaving me 31 seconds left in this first half where I almost threw a pick. That is the exact reason why I don't like to take that seam route up the middle, and on 3rd and 10, I'm probably not going to do it as they've just sent in a blitz, and we're going to take it to the half. It's a good thing that we get the ball to start the second as well, where Malachi Harris got tripped up, and now on 2nd and 6, I'm just going to wait in the pocket to see if something gets open, but I'm going to have to use my legs instead. I don't like that I have to hand it off on 3rd down, but Calvin Gibbs gets it, and it is remarkable that our coach just doesn't feed him the ball. He only has 2 rushes in this game. We might have another deep play, and that's put perfectly on the money. We are really starting to work it down the field on Kentucky. I got a couple of good blocks on this one, and Calvin Gibbs is going to have to do something with this screen pass where it goes over to him, and he picks up the first. We just need like 8 more yards now, and it looks like they've been faked out by the read option. So I rushed for another touchdown, but they scored again, and it's a good thing they didn't get the 2-point conversion, so they're only up by 5. Here on 2nd and 10, I'm hoping for man-to-man coverage, but it's zone, so I'm going to try to dot it up, and I can't. But it's not my fault. That ball was put exactly where it needed to be, and I'm not sure if Jay Stone the second's going to get us the first. But thankfully, he did, keeping this drive alive, and now I'm going to have Evan Carter Jr. over there. The pressure is on going into the fourth quarter, and we couldn't pull away in the end versus Cincinnati, so I'm hoping that we're able to do it against Kentucky, where Malachi Harris just fumbled it to Evan Carter Jr., but he picks it up, and he takes it all the way. I've never seen something like that happen. But with a 2-point conversion, we could find ourselves with a 3-point lead, and I think I have to do it with my legs. Our defense would then force an interception, so we're in a fantastic position. But the one thing I could not do there was take a sack, and I just have to find Evan Carter Jr., who goes down to the 3. All it took was our defense getting 1 stop, and now we've been able to pull away. But it isn't over yet, as Kentucky's going to kick a field goal here, and it's on me to help us run out the clock, but coach is calling passing plays instead of running ones. I guess that's a good thing, as we're going to have to get this 2nd and 12, and I'm going to have Dalen Maurice, who comes away with it. But now the rest of this game's in the hands of Calvin Gibbs, who gets 5, and all we need is 1 first down to seal the result against the Wildcats, which we are going to get. It's honestly remarkable that we were able to come away with the upset, and now I feel like we could take down any team, but I'm going to have to play as well as I did in this one, where I did enough to win my first MAC player of the week. That's going to get me up to 18,000 points, and I wanted to save them, but I have to upgrade my throw accuracy here, so I'm getting very close to becoming a 99 overall, and we have another rivalry game coming up, but first I want to try to become a team captain by getting my coach trust up. Having the ability to call extra plays whenever my coach makes the wrong decision is literally game-changing, so we really need it. And I'm going to do everything I can in my power during this practice to put up as many points as possible as we get a touchdown. And I wasn't sure if it'd even be possible to get as much coach trust as I need, but now I'm starting to have some hope. With 15 reps left, we're getting closer. But I've also had a lot of big plays in order for that to be a reality, and we're going for another where that DB stuck with him. I cannot believe I just threw an interception there, but I was hoping we could have had a touchdown, and instead it didn't happen. So I'm sorry, boys, but no matter what I do in this practice, it won't be enough. I'd end up throwing another interception as well, so our coach trust is only at about 500, but Calvin Gibbs is going to take it to the end zone, and I think this is the most XP I've ever gotten from a practice. It's not going to help us in this regard, but as the weeks go on, I'm going to want to spend some more, and I'm just waiting for a good awareness upgrade. It's about time that we finally get the play at home, though, and we are starting out with the ball where Calvin Gibbs is just going to get locked up here, but he broke the tackle, so he actually got a positive gain, and I really don't like whenever we have to run all those wide receiver and halfback screens, so I'm glad on third and one, I'm going to be able to actually make a read, and I'm just going to have Daylon Maurice over the middle of the field taking it to the 40. I've never been able to take down our rivals Western Kentucky, but I've also never gotten a start against them either, so I'm hoping that this one can go as well as the Kentucky game did, but they've already gotten in pressure, and I tried to escape the pocket, but I wasn't quick enough. Now we have to feed it to Daylon again, which seems to be going pretty well for us, so I can't complain with how we've started this game off, and Calvin Gibbs is fighting. He keeps getting better and better the older he gets, and we should be able to pick up this third and three where our tight end is open, and that's down at the one. From here, we should be able to pretty simply just punch it in, but Calvin Gibbs messed that up, so I'm going to get credit for the touchdown. Unfortunately, our defense wouldn't get a stop, though, so it's 7-7 when we get the ball back, and I absolutely love this play if they show us the right coverage, but they didn't, so I'm not going to have the deep route I wanted. This bubble screen makes me very nervous, but our tight end is going to be able to catch it and get us like 15 yards, so I still have yet to make a mistake in this game, but they're all over the run. And on 2nd and 15, our hitch route's probably the only thing that's open, but McCray actually got the pick, and I didn't think he could play that. I cannot believe we just turned it over like that, and we've gotten the ball back inside our own 5-yard line, which isn't good. We'd have to go the length of the field if we want to put up points here, and I'm terrified of taking those hitch routes now, but it worked out for us in that situation, and I just have to make sure that they don't have a player in a quarterback contain. I am going to try and scramble here, which is going to move the chains for us again, but if we're going to finish this drive with a touchdown, we still have a long way to go, and I cannot believe that Malachi Harris dropped that ball, but now we're going to go over to Dunn, and that was the right decision. I'm probably just going to step up in the pocket and try to scramble on this play, but they are all over me, and because of how hard I got hit, I am on the sidelines because I got injured. I mean, I'm happy to see we still got a field goal out of this drive, but Western Kentucky would end the first half with a touchdown, so we find ourselves down by 4 points. That honestly might have been the longest run of Calvin Gibbs' career, though, on that last play. He's been very solid, and with 2 runs, he's gotten us to a 3rd and 1 situation where he was open for a second, but I took it way too late, so we're attempting a 52-yarder, and our kicker must be insane, but that's good to know. Now on a 2nd and 13, I think the best thing I could do in the situation is run around and try to feed it to our tight end, who comes away with that football, and I am terrified of standing in the pocket for too long with our offensive line. Even though we haven't played the best, we are fortunately still in this game, and we need to get a touchdown out of this drive. I'm sick of only getting field goals, as that's going to be a good throw, but we still need about 20 more yards, and our backup tight end didn't catch it. This is where things could go downhill for us with this play calling, and it is why I need the option to change our play calls before MAC conference play starts, but maybe I'll have enough coach trust. That completion makes it 1st and goal, and Calvin Gibbs gets us to the 1, so we'll see how we open up the 4th quarter, and this is set up for me to get another rushing touchdown, but I'm a quarterback, and I think I've run for more touchdowns than I've passed for this year. The 2-point conversion's also very important as he goes down short, but our defense has gotten them to a 3rd and 15, where Veltkamp throws it well off target. With 4 minutes left on the clock, there's a chance that they never see the ball again, but I can't turn on Chew Clock and Road to Glory, so we're probably gonna have to move it all the way down the field, and I had to wait a long time for that to get open. I'm still very confident whenever it comes to feeding Jace Dunn the second. He doesn't make many mistakes, and my coach is not giving us running play calls, but passing ones instead. You would think that he would want us to just run out the rest of the clock, but that doesn't seem to be the case, and if I need to, I will put on a clinic by taking all of these checkdowns over and over. As of right now, I am 25 for 29 in this game, so I've played pretty well besides that one interception, and it is about time that we start to run the ball where I pitch it over to Calvin Gibbs, and he's going to get a couple. However, because of the hit that I took on this play, I would get injured, so I'm not out there for this 3rd and 6 that we don't get. Western Kentucky is going to have a chance to tie it up and send it to overtime, but they're already in a 4th and 10 situation where they are simply not going to pick it up, so we're going to take down our rivals, the Hilltoppers, at home, and that is a great start to the season where I could have just gone down early on, but I wanted to get my rushing yards up, and Calvin Gibbs is going to get the final play of the game. We're sitting at 2-1 before we start MAC conference play, so I'm pretty happy with how our team is doing, but but it's clearly a must that I have to become a team captain soon, and I think it's time we become a 99 overall by upgrading our throw accuracy by 1, upgrading our acceleration by 2, and then getting our awareness up to an 82. Apparently that only makes us a 98 though, and I just spent a lot of skill points, so now I have to earn some of them back. The main goal of this practice is it to be the one where I earn enough coach trust as well to start calling some extra plays, and Evan Carter Jr. always seems to be open. Our tight end is incredible, and on this play, he is as well. By the end of practice, I don't think I've earned enough coach trust to get to 1,000, but I have gotten us a lot closer, so hopefully after our next matchup, I will be able to start calling extra plays, because that would literally be game-changing for us, and it's time to see who the best team in the MAC is. On paper, Northern Illinois is better than us, so if we're gonna take down the Huskies, we cannot make many mistakes, and this could be the best start ever if we're able to make this catch. But unfortunately, Dalen Maurice just couldn't bring it in, and I even upgraded my awareness, so I don't know what else I could possibly do. He's just gonna need to develop more, and Evan Carter Jr. is always open, so I will continue to feed the junior, and with this quarterback draw, I think this is the best one's ever gone. We now find ourselves in a 2nd-and-1 situation where, again, I'm going to hit the junior tight end, and the Huskies defense has shown no resistance to stopping us so far during this drive as Dalen Maurice picks it up, but this is where things get tight down on the goal line, and that's a bad throw. I'm pretty sure I didn't set my feet, so that one is my fault, and I don't want to force anything on this 3rd-and-11, so I think we're just going to have to take our field goal. It's always hard to get into the end zone from there, and Northern Illinois has scored again, so we find ourselves trailing by 11. There's a chance this is our toughest game of the season, and we just had back-to-back drops, so we have to have a catch on 3rd down, and finally we do. I will take back pretty quickly, though, that this could be our toughest game, because I just remembered that Ohio State is on our schedule, and I am not looking forward to that one. Here on 3rd-and-10, we have to pick this up, and I floated it in the air. I don't know what I was thinking, but by the time we're getting the ball back, it is 21-3, and I just have to go deep and hope for the best where we make the catch. But Jace Dunn II really bailed me out here, and if I have ever deserved to throw an interception in a game, it is definitely this one. Their defense is just really good, and I don't see anything getting open here. I'm not able to scramble around. So now it's 3rd-and-8, where we have got to finish this drive off, and we are going to pick it up to Evan Carter Jr. We cannot get held to a field goal if we want any chance of winning this game. I should have made a read there, but I hate throwing it when we're this close to the goal line, and there we go. Jace Dunn II is going to get it back within 11 points, but they're going to end the first half by kicking a field goal, and I don't think I played that bad, but we find ourselves down by 2 scores versus the Huskies here. Now, when I watch this back, obviously I'm going to see some stuff that I don't see whenever I'm commentating live, and you all always make sure to point out in the comments the reads that I miss, but you have to keep in mind it's a lot easier to see it later on, and I also do like to stare down one receiver. I feel like I'm getting better at looking at multiple players though, so maybe that's why this drive is going so well, and Jace Dunn II brings that one in. On this next play, I am going to run around to this left side of the field and then throw it on the run to Carter Jr., so my improvising skills are getting a lot better, and Dalen Maurice takes it to the 2. It looks like the backup running back is in with this halfback toss play, and Marks doesn't get it. So now my coach is going to let me throw the ball, and I wanted to pick apart these zones, but I was scared to do it, and we fumbled it away to them. That turnover alone might cost us the game, but our defense has finally gotten us the ball back without giving up any points, and if we're able to get it inside the 10 again, I can't crumble versus Northern Illinois. That was definitely one of those plays where if I could, I would have changed the play call, and Dalen Maurice is starting to drive me insane. How is he not holding on to the football? I was hoping we'd go for it there, but our coach decided to settle for 3, and luckily for us, the Huskies only got a field goal on their next drive, so technically, with 3 timeouts left, we're not out of this game yet, but we need to score very quickly, and I think we're gonna have to do it by going deep to one of our receivers who is open, and they got over to it. This is the game right here, and I'm gonna have to make a hot read. I saw it get open the last time, and now we find ourselves on the other side of midfield, where I'm gonna hope that last second Malachi Harris can get open here. I've put it perfectly on the money, but they intercept it. They got over to the football. That was a stupid turnover for me again, but I feel like it was the right read in that situation, trying to get us points as quick as possible, and we're gonna have to recover an onside kick if we're able to reach the end zone to still have a chance in this one, where I'm gonna go deep and Harris takes it to the house. My fingers are crossed that we can come away with this football, but it was a bad kick. We didn't have a chance of recovering it, and we're gonna drop our 2nd game of the season to the Huskies, but believe it or not, it's actually not the end of the world, because I'm continuing to get better as a player, and as long as we beat every single one of these teams in our division, we can still make it to the MAC championship. Besides the Ohio State game, our schedule is about to get 10 times easier, and we also have a bye week before we play Western Michigan, so I'm gonna have plenty of time to get 13 more coach trusts, and that means extra plays would be available to call versus the Broncos, which would be huge. All we need is one more completion, and we're gonna get there. I think I might be able to pick it up with my legs as well, with this run going to the 20, and I ended practice right after that, because I cannot risk turning the ball over in any of the other plays. So there we go, I've become the team captain, and next up would allow us to have hot routes. We're starting to progress progress more and more. But I gotta say, if we're gonna win our conference, we cannot lose any more MAC games, and that is dropped. It is so frustrating that I can put the ball exactly where it needs to be and it doesn't seem to matter, but we catch that. And honestly, the one goal for this game is to not throw a single interception. I've been turning the ball over way too much recently. Dunn the second takes it to the 25, but he fumbled it away to Western Michigan, and that wasn't even my fault. The Broncos offense would also get a touchdown out of it, so we find ourselves down 7-0. And I still don't know how it's going to be possible to win a national championship and the Heisman with this team, but those were the two big goals for this series, and next year we're going to have to really figure things out. We've continued to improve this year, but I think at this rate the only realistic goals we can have is making the MAC championship. And it's rare to see our star tight end drop the ball, but he almost stalled out this possession. At some point we're going to have to wake up as a team and simply perform better against some of our opponents, so I'm hoping that we can do that to finish out the rest of this game. And I'm hoping that we don't struggle as much down inside the red zone now that I have the option to change the play call, but I'm just going to scramble to the 5. And from here we're keeping it on the ground where Calvin Gibbs gets a couple, but that's not going to help us very much, and I'm going to take it in. Western Michigan would score again, so it is 14-7 by the time that we're getting this ball back. And I thought that our defense might be a little bit better when we got to MAC conference play since we're playing against some weaker opponents, but that has not been the case. And I was hoping for man-to-man coverage because I assumed that Malachi Harris would be open, and he was, but he dropped the ball, and with this 3rd and inches, Calvin Gibbs is not going to get it. We had to punt it back to them where they scored another touchdown on us, and I am about to lose my mind. With how bad our team is performing right now, I'm going to have to step up and somehow make us win. I seem to be the only player out there on the field that can consistently help us get a lot of yards, and I cannot turn it over now. We have got to get some yardage here, and come on. If I just had a little bit more time, I would have had a big completion, but it all worked out because we still picked up that 3rd down, and their defensive end was quick, but not quick enough. Evan Carter Jr. is going to get it back within 7 points, and they literally scored within like 30 seconds to go up by 14 again. Our defense has gotten shredded, and on this 3rd and 9, they're going to throw an interception. So that is the only thing giving me any hope in this game, because they were about to go up by 3 possessions on us, and I am so glad I was watching that play. I did not realize how big of an impact that could be. I honestly thought we were about to go down 35-14 to open up this second half, but instead we have it, and I don't know why we're starting to run the ball so much. It doesn't work that well, but I am sick of it because I want to go back to throwing it through the air instead of handing it off. This is a huge 3rd and inches, and we ended up keeping it on the ground, but it did work out for us, and my goal is to roll out to take this to Jace Dunn the second, but that isn't open, and I just got to go down. I probably could have forced it there, but it would have ended really bad for us. Carter the Jr. is going to take it to the 5, and here we go. This is a game-changing 3rd and 4 where I am probably just going to try to do it with my legs, but I was marked short, and now I'm holding my chest, and I have to watch us make the worst decision ever. I mean, our defense would hold them, but we still find ourselves losing by a lot, and our tight end is open down the field. Come on, Evan Carter Jr., break free here. Just go all the way to the end zone, and you do. What a turnaround to end that 3rd quarter. I didn't think we'd pull it off, but then they scored a 77-yard touchdown, and even though I'm back from injury out there on the field, I can't even be excited because we're down by so much. This is not the time for our coach to be calling running plays, but he is, and I hate this halfback draw one, so we're going with verticals. That is why we needed this option available, but still, nothing is getting open versus the man-to-man coverage besides maybe Daylon Maurice, and he is actually going to reel it into the house. That is a nice 69-yard touchdown to get us back within a possession, and I'm going to have to use one of our extra plays on the 2-point conversion. This is simply too important for us to not pick up, and I don't really see anything, but maybe I can do it with my legs. But that did not work out, and on 3rd and 24, please do not give this up, defense. Just get the interception here. I mean, it worked out because then they'd miss that 54-yard field goal. I don't know why they even attempted it, but Calvin Gibbs breaks the tackle, and I cannot believe we still have a chance to win this game. I can't take the sack, but I knew it was coming. I saw it from a mile away, and that's why I've been instantly rolling out. This is a pretty big 3rd and 8 where I'm throwing it straight to our tight end. They almost got the interception there, and it's saying he's not down, so he gets up and gets some extra yardage. Normally, the play would just end there, but it was obvious he was going to get up from it, and I'm going to let Calvin Gibbs go to work by hitting him to take it inside the red zone, and I don't know why our coach is calling timeouts. We need to run off as much clock as possible here, and I hope that the pressure doesn't get to me. I honestly just want to use my legs, but our running back is open, and that's a touchdown. I hope I didn't leave them too much time, but I'll feel a lot better about it if we're able to get this 2-point conversion, and I didn't even look at the right side of the field, so I made a mistake. We'll see what happens to end this game. This is honestly the worst, having to watch this from the sidelines as our defense almost gets a pick, and I am terrified that they're going to have a big play or something, but they're not going to get this out. So there's just 9 seconds left now, and that's not going to get them in field goal range. All we have to do is not give up like a 70-yard Hail Mary where we got a sack, and I cannot believe that we're going to beat Western Michigan here at home. I thought we were done. My adrenaline is racing after getting my team the win, and this has to be the best stat line that I have ever put up, so I shouldn't be surprised that I won my first NCAA Player of the Week. and I'm just hoping that eventually I will get noticed in the Heisman watch. There's honestly not any upgrades here that I think are worth taking, but I should mention that we're already earning a lot of coach trust. So before we play our next conference game, I'm going to try to earn some more. And it doesn't even bug me that this practice is in the rain because I am so thrilled with that result against Western Michigan. I'm obviously going to expect a lot of drops because of the weather, and there's one. But it's Dalen Maurice, so I don't think anybody watching would even be the slightest bit surprised. And I can't believe I just turned it over like that. I always seem to make the dumb reads in these practices, which just hurts my coach trust. I came into this one hoping to earn some, but instead I just want to get some more player XP so when the good upgrades become available, we can afford it. And I finished practice pretty strong, so I'm up to almost 500 coach trust now, and I'm ready to play another home game. I'm coming off my best game ever, so we should perform pretty well against the Bearcats. My offensive line just had some amazing blocks on that play, and this run's going to continue to go. So I'm starting to use my legs a little bit more, especially when nothing is going to be open. Here on 2nd and 12, it is man-to-man coverage, but the corner routes did not get open. So that will make it a 3rd and long for us, and I think the odds of picking this up aren't great, but we're actually going to do it to Malachi Harris. I'm starting to actually love this Northern Kentucky team and how everybody's developing, but in the next season and a half, there's still so much that all of these players are going to have to achieve, and Evan Carter Jr. dropped the ball. That is not something he normally does, but we're still going to move the chains. And now that we've gotten down inside the red zone, it's going to be the question of whether or not we can finish it off, so I think we're going to use my legs to do that, and we go to the 4. I really don't like some of these passing plays that they call down here, so I try to step up in the pocket. I've broken one sack. How am I still going here? What is happening? I wish they would stop putting out these simple hitch routes on the field because they don't get open, and none of the change play options were great either, so this is the best that we have. But it worked for us there, and then our defense got a stop, so I'm happy with how things are going. Calvin Gibbs goes for 8, and that makes this a very manageable 3rd and 2, where both of those hitch routes just stopped in the same spot. I was gonna take one of them, but they decided to be right next to each other instead. Calvin Gibbs breaks that one tackle, and with 4.5 minutes left in the second quarter, Ohio has tied it back up at 7, but I'm not worried because I know we're the better team, and we definitely have the better quarterback. If I can continue to play this well, I'll honestly believe that I'm the best quarterback in the country, and stat-wise, I probably am since I've gotten myself up to a 99 overall. I need to be able to lead this team to a MAC championship, though, and our corner route is wide open, so we're very close to reaching the end zone, and the slant got boxed. Our receivers really aren't that good. I make them look a lot better, and after reaching the end zone again, our defense would go out and hold the Bobcats, so we have an opportunity to take a 2-possession lead, and that's going to be a laser. I'm so used to us playing in close games this season that it would be weird if we had a big lead over the Bobcats in this one, but it would also be nice because then the pressure wouldn't be as immense as it has been recently, and all I have to do is make sure I don't throw an interception where Dalen Maurice brings it in for a touchdown. They would follow that up with a touchdown though, so by the time we have the ball back here in the 3rd quarter, we only have a 7-point lead, and it is crucial that we have yet another good drive where they are about to get a sack, and I can't believe I made both of those players miss the sack, but I'm just going to complete this to Evan Carter Jr. to about midfield, and he is continuing to run. I do not know how he is still standing, but there is a reason that the junior is my favorite target, and my hope was man-to-man coverage on this play because there's a route that normally gets open versus it, but it wasn't there, so instead I'm going to take off on the ground using my legs, and I'm going to go all the way down to the 1. All I needed was another yard to get the touchdown, but I'll do it here, and we must have forced a turnover if we have the ball back this quickly in this position. It is so nice that this one is not as tight as some of the recent matchups. I'm appreciative of it, and it's allowing me to comfortably sit back there, look at whoever's open, and Evan Carter Jr. wasn't there. I tried to get him a touchdown, but even with 96 throw accuracy, I'm still missing some throws, so that's Heisman for you, but Malachi Harris catches that. And even though the Bobcats would score again, we're in the driver's seat in this game because we're up by 14 with the ball with less than 4 minutes left. And I'm honestly just going to continue to pad my stats because I think I've rushed for over 100 yards, which is something I don't think I've done before, and that shows I'm starting to become a dual threat. I feel like there's still a chance I could sneak into the Heisman conversation as well if I keep putting up good stats, but Calvin Gibbs dropping that ball is going to cut that drive short. And in the end, we're going to get the right result versus Ohio. I'm very happy with how my stats looked as well, which has been earning me a lot of XP recently, and also coach trust as I'm about to unlock Hometown Hero. So that's exciting, and let's make sure that I boost up my awareness and also my speed and acceleration here. I don't know why I thought I had 96 throw accuracy, but apparently I don't. But it's fine because the rest of my stats look really good. From the looks of these division standings, all we have to do is continue to win out to make the MAC championship, but before then, we have to play at Ohio State, and I've already accepted that this could be rough. I think this game could teach us a lot about our team though and how we compete against better schools. So it's nice to see our first offensive play go for 27 yards. And the Buckeyes scored 7 pretty quickly against us, but that's no surprise. Calvin Gibbs is going to make it all the way to the 45. But coach wants me to have another halfback screen to him for our third down play call, and that was actually the right decision to make. We're getting closer and closer to reaching the end zone versus the Buckeyes. I need my offensive line to step up though. And nobody got open versus their man-to-man coverage, which just is upsetting to see. I know we're at least in field goal range, but we have to get as many points in this game as we can, and I'm going to try to scramble for it where I am going to pick it up on the ground. And that actually gets me a little bit of hope versus the Buckeyes because we're competing with them pretty well. To end the first quarter, we could tie it up at 7-7 if I'm able to make the right read, but I didn't want to force it into a tight window. So I'll gladly take my check down, and it's not going to work this time. We can't keep running halfback screens, but that's what my coach loves to do. And if this C route goes for a touchdown, that'd be awesome. To everybody's surprise, Daylon Maurice actually held on to the football, and the Buckeyes only got a field goal out of their next drive. So if we have a good one here, we could take the lead, and I'm forcing it into that one to Dunn. Right now, we are thriving, but the wide receiver screen got boxed. So that's my first incompletion of the day, and I almost took that route again, but I got worried, and now I'm going to get sacked. I cannot be hesitating versus teams like the Buckeyes, and that comeback route was boxed up. But somehow, Daylon Maurice made the catch, and I should have thrown an interception there, but they didn't turn around quick enough, which is amazing. That's going to keep our drive alive, and I'm going to have to go for the end zone shot where they aren't going to make a play on it. So Jace Dunn the second puts us up by 4 points, and it wouldn't last since they'd scored to end the half, but we still have 16 seconds to get into field goal range ourselves. I truthfully believe that we can make it happen as long as some of our receivers get some yards after the catch here, and he doesn't. So we're going to need a little bit more to even attempt this with our kicker, and that drag should do the trick as long as Harris goes down in time, which he does. I don't think I could have had a better first half than what I just did, and the pressure is on for us to pull off the upset here in the third quarter. Anytime we have struggled to do something, we have made up for it on the next play, but our zig route did not get open, and on 3rd and 12, there's only one player I could really take here where he drops the ball. It should be no surprise that Daylon Maurice lets us down, and they would also score a touchdown where they're getting in pressure here, but we have a deep post open, and Daylon Maurice is going to make up for his drop by reeling in that catch, and he is going to go down at the 1. That was exactly what we needed in that situation there, but our defense has got to step up, and on 3rd and 8, they're going to get the interception. Booker comes away with the football, and they're not going to make the tackle on him either. I cannot believe that we just got the turnover we needed, but we might actually beat the Buckeyes. That was insane. I was certain that they were going to get at least a field goal there, but instead we're just going to hand this one off to our fullback, and I don't like any of these third down play calls, but quarterback draws probably our best option, so that's what we decided to go with, and I hate that we're settling for a field goal. It's no surprise Ohio State's going to respond back, and I've been given a chance with 51 seconds left, but that's a bad play call. Our coach really doesn't want to see us succeed, but I can change it. So that's why it was so crucial for me to unlock that, but they've boxed up all of our slants. And why would that even be an option for 3rd and 10? I gotta change it again. My hot read is gonna be tight end Evan Carter Jr., who eventually would have been open, but I needed another second to throw it. And it is 4th and 17, where I'm gonna have to try and force it into a tight window to pick this up, but they're gonna get the sack and we fumbled it away. Our defense would force a fumble though, so we still somehow have a chance with 19 seconds left, and I have learned that I should probably just do things on the ground because through the air has not been working. That leaves us with about 12 seconds left, and if this is cover 2, we are going to throw the 4 verticals over to Jace Dunn the second, and with that, I'm able to set a school record. But what's important is what happens on this Hail Mary, and I'm going to set us up even better. We lost to Cincinnati on the same play, and the tight end didn't get open, but we might have one of our receivers deep, and it is dropped. We're going to fall short of beating another big school, but it came down to this, and that was so close to actually working in our favor. From this point, though, we should be able to win the MAC conference, because it's obvious that we have a solid enough roster, and I tried to play my best, but it wasn't enough. That's honestly the worst, but we just need 50 more coach trust to become the hometown hero, so I might as well make that happen, and they've sent in a blitz, which results in a sack. I cannot catch a break right now. That's going to make it even more difficult to unlock it, but we'll do it. And it's also important for me to get some more XP so I can upgrade my speed and the rest of my player. I was kind of worried that that could turn into an interception, and now we're just going to bomb them deep, which is going to get us pretty close to having enough trust. So all we need is a few more completions, and after that, I'm ending practice because I cannot risk having any mistakes. I think one more will do it here, and that's what we're going to take on the sidelines, which means I can now call hot routes during some of our home games. And honestly, that's a pretty big deal because we're about to play Akron at home, so that should help us go out and get the win versus them. To open up this big conference game versus Akron, we have the ball first, and I'm going to try to fit it into that tight window. So that's a solid start for this offense, and we're going to do the same thing on this next play, and it looks like we're going to get a touchdown as well, as Harris has broken free. Malachi Harris has some good plays and also some bad ones, but at least he's helped us open up this game in the best way possible, and Daylon Maurice is also catching it. Our offense has been flying down the field so far, and the quarterback draw gets us 10. So Akron's in a ton of trouble, but we didn't get anywhere on first down with a run, so now we've given it to Calvin Gibbs again, and he gets like 30, 40 yards as he continues to go. I can also call hot routes now, which really helps down inside the end zone, so we should be able to score here. Malachi Harris is open, and that's a touchdown. I'm also thrilled with the fact that our defense has been able to get 2 stops already in this game. So as our offense is getting better, our defense is as well, and I'm hoping to have a big run here, but they're going to stop me. It was still a perfect first quarter from us, and the Zips might be able to get us off the field on this 3rd and 4 as they're over the halfback screen, but I'm not worried about it, even though they would get a field goal next, because we're still up by 2 possessions versus them, and I'm just going to take that underneath. But because I'm short, it was almost picked. I've got to be more careful in those situations, and Malachi Harris lost the ball, but we bounced on top of it, so we still have possession of it, and we should be fine, except I didn't see that defender, so I should have thrown an interception there, and it looks like on 2nd and 10, they're going to box me up, except I was able to scramble to the outside, which just shows that now I can get out of almost any situation, and I cannot believe I threw that straight to them, but we did not create any separation there, and on this play, Daylon Maurice is going to take it down to the red zone. We're getting closer and closer to me throwing for my 3rd touchdown. Their defensive line is not going to generate pressure quick enough, and now that I can put slants out on the field down inside the red zone, it should be so much easier to get in, which we do. Now, our defense is starting to fall apart, but I'm not even worried about it, because they've shown that they cannot stop our offense, and here to end the first half, we might get another field goal as well. I mean, we still have 30 seconds to get in range, so it's not like it's going to be too difficult for us to do as we do it here. And if we're going to get a 4 verticals play call, there's always the chance that I could go for another touchdown, which I'm getting. I think Malachi Harris just caught his 3rd of the day, and my coach does not like to call running plays, because even though we have such a huge lead, we're coming out in the second half still slinging it with 4 verticals. And if I can finish off this game as strong as I've started it, there's a good chance I could be in the Heisman race. To be honest, I feel like the only thing holding me back from doing so is the fact that I play for Northern Kentucky, but I'm going to evade that pressure. I'm not going to get sacked, and I'm taking it to the 10. I'm hoping for my 5th passing touchdown of the day on this drive, which I should have gotten. And I can't believe Malachi Harris just dropped that ball, but we're going to roll out. There's a slant I could take, and they were playing it, so we're going to run into the end zone instead. At this point in the game, I don't think Akron's going to be able to come back, as we have a great lead over them. Calvin Gibbs is going to lose the football. And are you kidding me? They've picked it up just when I was saying I don't think the Zips could come back in this game. And that's nuts that they got the football there, but they wouldn't score a touchdown on that drive. And I have noticed that they are pressing star tight end Evan Carter Jr. with a linebacker. I know that he can outrun him, and that ball was put perfectly on the money. He is going to continue to run. He's broken multiple tackles, and I'm starting to play like a 99 overall quarterback. It turns out that being able to put hot routes out there on the field has changed everything for us, and it's been very rare for us to blow out any team in this series, but we might start doing it. I'm honestly going for another passing touchdown just because I can, and I'm not getting benched for the backup, and it looks like I've broken one of my own records. I knew that this could turn into one of the best games of my career, but from there, my coach would obviously put the backups in, so I'll have to settle for having 7 total touchdowns. And this next MAC conference game is super important for us. It's versus one of the better teams in our division, and because I'm only a hometown hero and not a field general, I can't call hot routes on the road, so this one could be difficult. And our defense has gotten us in a fantastic position to start this game, because they were able to force a turnover on Miami, Ohio. Getting us an interception so we can score the first points is such a big deal. Calvin Gibbs is going to go to the 7, and my head coach clearly wants me running a ton of screen plays in this game, but so far they've worked, and with the read option, Calvin Gibbs goes nowhere. I really wish I could put some slants out there on the field with some hot routes. They're going to get the sack and the fumble, so we didn't get any points out of that drive, and I had no time back there. Now it's 2nd and 7, where I've decided that I wasn't going to pitch it to Calvin Gibbs because I couldn't risk turning the ball over again, and we're going to move the chains on 3rd down. Being able to use hot routes at home to change up all of these hitch routes is a huge deal, because whenever it's man-to-man coverage, nothing's open, and I'm not risking throwing it for like 3 yards whenever there's a defender right next to them. This is not going to work. So it is 3rd and 17. They've gone with man-to-man coverage, and I have to hope that Calvin Gibbs can outrun 23, but it looks like he was able to do it. There is one good thing about our offense, and it's that all our guys are quick. So approaching the end of the first quarter, we are still up by 7, and our defense has done their job so far. If the rest of our team can improve enough during the offseason, I think next year we could make a playoff run. So that's going to be exciting to see if it happens, and I simply have to do my part in continuing to improve my player. I want to try to hit our tight end over the top. He had a stop and go route there, and he is just quicker than 16. He has gone to the crib. I've never tried to bomb a team over the top with a route like this before, but the stop and go was just enough for him to get a little bit of an extra burst. And Miami Ohio's offense has been terrible, so we're going to have it back up 14. I think we got all of our hard matchups out early on in this video, and I feel like things would have been a lot different if we didn't take down Western Michigan. This third down didn't go well. And all of a sudden, the Redhawks have it within 7 points, so it's not over as we approach halftime. But I'm starting to figure out that against these weaker teams, I have more time back there in the pocket, and if I need to, I can escape to the outside, which I've done on this play, and that takes us to the 25. I'm obviously going for another touchdown, and the man-to-man coverage is not going to work against Josiah Brown. So we'll continue to fly down the field, and with the option, I should have pitched it. That's on me for getting greedy and thinking that I could reach the end zone by myself. Dalen Maurice takes it in, and we get the ball to open up the third quarter, so Miami Ohio is in a ton of trouble. You would think that our play calling would be a little bit more passive now, but our coach wants us to run up the score versus every team, and this is one of the first times in Road to Glory where I have liked a majority of the play calls that I've gotten from my head coach. It looks like Dalen Maurice makes the catch, and I am 15 for 16 for almost 300 yards on Heisman mode with Northern Kentucky. This is insane. I know I'm a 99 overall quarterback in a bad conference, but I started as a 45, and I honestly didn't think I would ever get to this point in the series. In the first episode in my freshman year, I wasn't even able to get onto the field once, but just two seasons later, I'm the best quarterback in the game at a 99 overall, and I'm hoping that I'm able to outrun both of these defenders, but they brought me down, so it is third and goal, and I don't want to force it here because I'd much rather us go up by three possessions. I guess it really doesn't matter whenever your defense forces a turnover down inside the red zone. Comeback routes are open, and Dalen Maurice is starting to really make a difference. Two plays later, we have the ball back again, so this is starting to get crazy, and it's about time that our defense started helping me out because they struggled for a lot of the series, and especially during some of the games in this episode as well, but I just want to make sure that I don't turn the ball over here, so I'll gladly check it down and let our kicker go out and drill it. I have found it pretty interesting that our head coach does not like to put the backups out there even when we're up by a ton, but this game's obviously already over, so unless we're in the red zone again, I'm pretty much just going to cut to the end. I mean, the Redhawks would score to get it back within 20 points, but that's still not close at all, and I wish I could turn on chew clock because with one first down, we could simply end the game, but that won't be the case even though we get it. Instead, we've been able to move it all the way down the field by simply handing it off, and I'd love it if I was able to go for just one more touchdown against them, but instead, we're going to send the field goal unit out there, and that is a great win on the road at Miami, Ohio. My stat lines are continuing to be great as well, so even though we could earn more coach trust through practice, I've honestly been skipping it, and we'll see if that comes back to bite us in the future. I'll probably miss out on a really nice upgrade or something, but there's only so many things that I can improve upon, and with three conference games left, all we have to do is win out. It looks like the MAC Conference Championship would be a rematch against Northern Illinois, and I'd love to get my revenge versus them, but for the first time I've appeared in the Heisman watch, so the most important thing about this series is I finished this season strong. I could actually win the Heisman Trophy as a junior, and I don't think I've ever done that in a Road to Glory before. Bowling Green has already sent in a blitz versus us, but clearly my awareness needs to be even higher because we still have players that aren't able to hold on to the football. This is a pretty big third and two where Bowling Green isn't going to stop us, and I remember playing here on the road last year because of how sick that backdrop is behind their end zone, so I don't know why they didn't come to our place this season, but it is what it is. All I have to do is make sure I don't take the sack, and I am going to avoid it by breaking that tackle and getting the first. We are going to open up things the right way with Evan Carter Jr. getting open on the corner route, and that means he's broken Dalen Maurice's record from last year. It's hard to believe with all the drop issues he's had that he had that from the past season, but we have an issue because after I got hit at the end of this play, I'm pretty weak, and that would end up being enough to injure me as I'm going to hold my chest. So I've had to watch the rest of this first drive from the sidelines, and on third and 11, Dunn the second's going to move the chains for us. We'd end up scoring a touchdown, and I'd be out there on our next drive, but missing out on scores like that could hurt my chance at winning the Heisman, and it's going to be hard to pick up this third and 14, but I'm going to hopefully do it over there to Malachi Harris. I hate facing off against man-to-man coverage whenever we play against bigger schools, and they actually got the interception out of man-to-man coverage there. But I was about to say I love it versus weaker schools, and that's the first time that I've turned over the ball in a while, so that's really frustrating to see. Evan Carter Jr. just didn't get open. We have 7 first downs to their 0, though, so it just shows that we're dominating. The score is also 7-0, so that's a cool thing. And I also want to make sure that I'm still putting up some decent rushing stats. Even though they're not calling design quarterback runs, I'll do it myself. And that's going to get us another first down where I'm just going to take this hitch, and that broke free upfield, but it helps us out. Something tells me we're going to be ranked very shortly, and getting Northern Kentucky there 3 years into this would be insane, but they have sent in a blitz, and I'm going to not go down. I've actually broken a tackle, so I don't know what happened there, but I cannot complain, and with this, we're just going to get a couple more. I'm still upset at myself for throwing that interception early on, but I'm going to make sure I don't do it again, and if that means only getting a field goal here, that's okay. I'm not going to force anything if I don't have to, but I can step up and run, which is going to lead to a touchdown. This has to be one of the filthiest spin moves in channel history, making 4 defenders miss a tackle on me, and we have instantly recovered a fumble. The play calling is terrible, but we have the ball back again, and that actually got open, so maybe the spacing play play versus man-to-man coverage isn't as bad as I thought it was throughout this video. There's still a few minutes left in the first half, but we could go up by 3 possessions. And unless we turn it over, it is locked in because a field goal would do that for us, but I'm just going to run and that will be a touchdown. So once again, this one already feels like it's over and we haven't even hit halftime yet, which is just crazy. Calvin Gibbs also broke free with the halfback screen and nobody is going to catch him. So that came out of nowhere and that's going to really help my chance at winning the Heisman because that counts as a long passing touchdown for me. I just realized that this is going to be an incredible senior year I'm going to have because we're playing in the MAC conference again and everybody keeps getting better. So I should dominate theoretically and it looks like they are going to lock us up on this play where I'm just going to try to run for it myself and I've made it to the 2. I'm honestly very excited to see how my senior year goes and the rest of this one because we should cruise to a lot of easy wins and I'm just going to do the smart thing. I have a feeling I'm about to get another touchdown even though Calvin Gibbs went backwards there because he got a positive gain. And the only thing that could really ruin our season right now is if we had any injuries, especially to myself. That has happened to us before, and on 3rd and 4, I am going to go up the middle of the field. So we're going up 42-0. And the fact that our defense is getting stops as quickly as they are is incredible. This is probably going to be picked, though. I shouldn't have floated it. And I always do something stupid. I mean, we're instantly going to get it back because our defense was able to get an interception on Bowling Green. But I am not happy with myself for having 2 interceptions in 1 game. And I better not get benched to start the 4th quarter. I simply want to finish off this drive and then they can pull me as we get in. So that's what happened and we'd end up winning 52-7. There's a lot of positive takeaways we can have from this game and one of them has to be my stat line without the interceptions. But because of them, I'm not going to have enough coach trust to be a team leader. And I thought it would affect my Heisman odds, but somehow I've shot up to number 1. All that's left on our schedule is Central Michigan and Buffalo, but we could still lose the tiebreaker if we lose both of these games. So we have to be a little careful and it looks like Northern Illinois has been ranked, but obviously we're not receiving votes, which means we still have a long way to go in this series. And Central Michigan could be difficult. They're 7-3 and looking to take us down, but hopefully we'll come out on top. Gibbs is going to get 4 here. And this is one of the most important games of my career because I'm so close to winning the Heisman Trophy. My stats must be insane or something, and I feel like Evan Carter Jr. is going to be able to run straight by them, so I've bombed it up to him. I've put it perfectly on the money. And originally, it looks like he drops the ball, but then he ended up catching it anyway, so he came up clutch. It also helps because we're at home, I can call hot routes, but I've hit the wrong button, getting it over to backup running back Marks. So I missed out on an easy touchdown, and we're just going to have to hope that somebody gets open, which we have on this play, Malachi Harris. Then our defense forced an interception. And where were all of these turnovers in the first half of the year when we were struggling so much? Now we're just dominating. I mean, even with us on the 5-yard line, they've gotten another stop, and I cannot take the safety here. I've got to outrun that defensive end, which I was able to do. Now I can get a block, and that's a great run. That was a little risky on my part, but my confidence is so high after how we've performed recently. Gibbs is going to get us a first, and I could have sworn he had it, but they said he was short, so we're going to have to pick it up to Daylon Maurice. I feel like the Grand Rapids series with those tough sliders has really helped me, because even though I know I've made some stupid turnovers in this video, I'm playing better than I normally would. And to end the first quarter, I'm hoping that we're able to move the chains where the checkdowns are really working for us right now. They make it take a little longer to score, but they've also made my stats look 10 times better this year, and with the pitch, Calvin Gibbs is going to get us 4. This is another one I feel like we're going to close out if we score on this drive, and I'm just able to run around everybody. I cannot believe how quick I've been able to make my player. It's only like 79 speed, but in the MAC conference, that's clearly all that you need, and Evan Carter Jr. gets us to the 3. We are cruising through this game, so we should make the MAC championship, and our defense has been incredible for us once again. I'm just going to hand this one off to Calvin, but they were ready for it, so we're going to try something like that again, and this time he gets us a little bit more. Apparently, I've already changed the play 5 times, though, so I have to hand it off with a halfback draw on 3rd down to him, and that was another upgrade that we could have really used in my sophomore year, but I'm glad that we have it now. If we could just score on this drive, that would be the last main bit of this game I'm going to show. I see a deep route streaking down the field to Jace Dunn, and if I set my feet, I could have led him a lot better, but I'm still terrified of my offensive line not holding their blocks for long enough, and they did that there. A fullback dive from the 4-yard line is an interesting play call, though, and I really wish I could change some of these, but there's nothing I can do. Here we go, 3rd and goal. I have the slant out there to Malachi Harris, and that touchdown pretty much secures our win. By the end of this one, I'm just going to continue to pad my stats, and it looks like they weren't expecting me to take off here, but my coach wants me to hand it off to Gibbs, so I'll do that. And that would be the final time in this game I'd see the field. With no turnovers, though, I'm very happy with my performance, and I had 5 passing touchdowns with almost 400 passing yards. I think at this rate, the Heisman race is going to be mine to lose, and I am so ready to have a chance at getting revenge versus Northern Illinois in the conference championship, but we have one more game that I have to play first, and if I perform well, I'm going to go from being a hometown hero to being a team leader. This is the final game of the regular season, so I'm hoping we can go out and get an easy win over them. Daylon Maurice already broke a tackle, but sometimes playing in the snow can be a little bit difficult, and it looks like our tight end created a ton of separation with that post route past midfield. We're flying so far, but with this handoff, Calvin Gibbs doesn't get much. So I don't love that we're going back to giving it to him again, and that makes it 3rd and 13 where they went with man-to-man coverage, and that's going to lead to us getting stopped. However, instead of taking our 3, coach wants us to go for it, and the halfback screen is not going to work. But it's all good. Buffalo didn't score, and we eventually would have the ball back. I want to take this wheel route to Malachi Harris, and he was in motion to start the play. Now he goes to the 45. So I thought that that was a cool little design, and I want to hit our tight end here, but I don't have time. Now, don't get me wrong. There were definitely other things open, but I wanted to beat them deep, and this time I did take the smart route over to Malachi Harris. But now we have to find a way to pick up this 3rd and 7, and I'm just going to roll out where we have gotten a perfect route bounce. I have hit Jace Dunn the second, and he is gone. Buffalo would also get stopped on our 2-yard line, so we have the ball, and Calvin Gibbs is going to get to the outside to get us out of a bad situation. From this point on the field, we should no longer have to worry about taking a safety against the Bulls, and I wish I could do some hot routes. I'm probably just going to send up a deep shot, seeing if Daylon Maurice can burn that corner, but unlike what he's been able to do against some of these MAC defenses, he couldn't do it there. And because I was staring down some deep routes, we'd take a sack, which has led to the Bulls tying it up at 7, so there's 1.5 minutes left now, and I would love to get some more points before the half, but we have to be smart about what we do, and it might just be me scrambling. I was in such a good groove when it came to making reads before I went and ate dinner. Now I feel like I'm going to miss some things, and that cannot be the case because we have some big matchups coming up, and I'm just going to try to avoid the sack, but he gets me. This has been a rough performance for a player that has a Heisman Trophy on the line, but we had it deep, and now I'm holding my chest after not getting it there. Well, somehow in the minute I wasn't out there on the field, we'd end up getting a safety against the Bulls, so the drive did not end well, but we're still up by 2, and we just got to take control in the 3rd quarter. That was a really bad drop there, though, making it so we have to convert on 3rd and 8, which we do, and I should probably just be smart and take my slant, but I thought everything was boxed up, so I've decided to run instead. I've been scrambling a lot more as of recently, so it's about time I pass it, and we are closing in on scoring on this drive. We just need to have a laser here, and it's dropped. If we didn't have to deal with so many of those, I wonder how good this team would have been during this season. And here on 3rd and 8, it is zone coverage, not man-to-man, so the route I wanted to take still got open. There was literally a defender right there, but for some reason, he did make a play on it, and that's big because I am in the running for the Heisman Trophy, where it is crucial that I finish off this game with some better numbers, and that stop-and-go route from our tight end worked again, but I overthrew him, and I'm going to be thinking about that one for a very long time. That would have been such an easy score for us, but at the end of the day, I'm going to make mistakes. I can't be a perfect quarterback, and my hope is that he can get open with another good route on this play, which he does, and that player cannot get back to the football. A quarterback sneak would be perfect in this situation, but they didn't give it to us, so I had to find Daylon Maurice instead for the touchdown, and a 2-point conversion would give us a 3-possession lead, but they get the sack. It's not going to matter because our defense has locked up for us, and I'm just going to step up if there's going to be this much space. They're literally dropping like 8 or 9 guys back into coverage, and I don't know what I need to do to make sure that they catch it more, but before next season, we have got to figure that out, and if I have a good drive, I think we can pretty much seal things. That route is so filthy versus man-to-man, but Malachi Harris cannot hold on to it for like the 5th time, and I don't even want to look in his direction on this play, but he's open, and there we go. I'm honestly excited to look at the season stats and see how many drops we experienced. I think it's going to be a lot, because they keep on occurring, and I just don't even want to take anything simple underneath. I would rather use my legs so it's not dropped at all. We're honestly just lucky that none of them have turned into interceptions for us, and this is a design quarterback run, which they weren't expecting, but I'm not going to get very far, except I have eventually broken free, and I'm still not quite sure how I was able to slip out of this one with that spin move. It would be huge if I could score at least one more touchdown in this game, because as of right now, this hasn't been the best of performances for a Heisman contender, and I have to make sure that I don't turn the ball over here when I want to laser it into tight windows, which I decided not to do. I got scared, but I think I had my tight end. I just didn't want to risk the interception, and I don't like how close everything is down here on the goal line because a lot of things aren't that open. Somehow that counts as a first though, and I just don't want to take Malachi Harris. He's probably not going to catch it, but if I would have done it from the beginning, he probably would have there. And on 3rd and goal, I am keeping this where the read option gets me in. You know what? At the end of the day, we got a big win over a conference opponent, and now we can celebrate it in the snow. So let's get ready for the MAC Conference Championship, and I'm going to continue to take these upgrades, which help me when it comes to how I run. Going into the final week of the season, I'm still in the lead for the Heisman, and then I saw this upgrade, which would max out my stamina and also limit the times I get injured. I think I'm taking a lot of good strides forward as a player, but my throw accuracy could still use some work. And it looks like going into the Conference Championship, Northern Illinois is 11-1. Their only loss came on the road at Ohio State, and if it wasn't for that, they'd be in the College Football Playoffs. The good news, though, is after last week, I'm a team leader, so I'm going to have a ton of extra plays available to use, and it is time to get revenge. This is my first ever Conference Championship game where the handoff goes nowhere, so I need my coach to keep the ball in my hands, and we are going to dot them up for the first down. Northern Northern Illinois did beat us earlier this season, but I feel like we've gotten a lot better since then, and I know that our slant's eventually going to get open to Malachi Harris, who takes it all the way to the 30. Even if the Huskies only losses to Ohio State, I feel like we could actually go out and take them down in this game. And on first and goal, I'm going to have somebody open where it is reeled in. Our defense would then get a stop on Northern Illinois, so we're off to a perfect start. And I've hated this spacing play all season, but the route bounces from it are really good that we couldn't take. Eventually, we will get that down, but now it is 3rd and 12, and we have to try to fit it over to Malachi Harris, where I'm just as shocked as you that he held onto the football, but maybe he's getting better. If I am going to win the Heisman Trophy, it's very important that I don't turn it over, and I think we're going to have a touchdown to Malachi Harris, as there's no one back there. But eventually, a safety would get over to it, and I'm just going to step up and run for the easy touchdown where I don't make it in. I've fumbled it away to the Huskies. Are you serious? That was so close to being a good play. And even though they wouldn't follow it up with a score, I hate seeing myself turn the ball over. I mean, we still have a lead to end the first quarter, but it should definitely be 14-0, so we have to just make this drive a smart one. If I'm remembering right, Northern Illinois was able to score a ton of points on our defense, so I'm not going to feel comfortable unless we're up by like at least 21 and I almost broke free, but I fumbled it away to them again. And I've really got to start sliding in this game. They'd only get a field goal, but I can't believe I just lost it there as well. And this is one of my favorite plays in the game, but they're going to get instant pressure. It always either goes for a big gain or a loss of yards, and coach forced me to run the ball on third down where I've just fumbled it for the third time. They've picked it up and I am just so upset. I've never seen something like this happen before, but I better step up, make some good reads, and end this first half of football in the right way. With the Heisman Trophy on the line, I feel like I'm choking, but you know what? I'm going to trust Malachi Harris to burn his man, and that's exactly what he does. The next time I'd get the ball then in the third quarter, it looks like we have forced a turnover around midfield, so that is a good sign of what is to come in the future. And this Northern Illinois team is tough. They're playing us extremely well, but I've also made a lot of mistakes, and we are very lucky that we somehow have a lead versus them. I want to hit Calvin Gibbs with the wheel route, and he's going to hang on. So we are closing in on going up by 11, and eventually our slant route's going to get open. Jace Dunn the second's had a quiet second half of the year, but that was really big for us because they would score on their next drive, and I'm just too short to complete that pass. That was hard to see, and the bubble screen has been locked up as well, which means it is third and long. Our corner route is open, and please just hang on to the ball. Right now, assuming we can finish this drive off, we're in a really good position, but we have to do it first. And I'm going to let Calvin Gibbs go to work with this halfback screen, but it looks like he's going to do that, getting the first down plus a lot more. For somebody that wasn't that good as a sophomore, he's made a massive stride forward as a junior, and I'm really excited to see how everybody on this roster plays as seniors. There's a lot of players that are juniors on here, and that includes every single one of our main receiving targets where we already have a ton of chemistry with them, but some of them have got to work on catching the ball, and on third and 10, I'm going to try to pick it up with my legs where I'm not going to reach the marker. Unfortunately, my coach didn't give me the option to go for it, so I've had to watch as my defense is struggling to get a stop versus the Huskies, and they're down to our 5. They'd eventually score a touchdown, but we have the ball back with a few minutes remaining, and whether or not we win a MAC conference championship is pretty much all in my hands, but they boxed that up, and I can't believe that just happened to our comeback route. I'm not sure if the hitch is going to make it to the marker, but it did, and that's all we needed to move the chains against the Huskies. I have very little control over what we do in Road to Glory, so I can't just settle for a field goal and chew clock, and I also can't put hot routes out there on the field, which means there was nothing on this play that I could take besides Calvin Gibbs in the flat. We're going to have to punt it back to them, and thankfully our defense clutched up for us. With about a minute on the clock, we have the ball approaching midfield, and all we have to get is a field goal, so I'm not that worried about it because I feel like we should be able to pull it off, and we have pretty much done that already. Our kicker has a big boot. He should make it from here, but I'm going to try to scramble for more, and their defensive linemen are quick. 15 seconds left on the clock now. All we have to do is make sure we don't turn it over, and my coach wants me to sling it, so I'll do that, but I just want to settle for 3. Finally, we've gotten a play call that's going to set us up to take the game winner, and junior kicker Jordan Rogers is going to put it down the middle. It was a close call, but we have taken down the Huskies, and I've gotten my revenge winning the Norse a MAC conference championship. You would think that this stat line would have won me player of the game, but because of my 3 fumbles, it went to Malachi Harris, and I'm just lucky that I'm still a team leader, but my main wonder is if I won the Heisman Trophy, and we're about to find out. To my surprise, it wasn't even close as I got so many first place votes, so as a junior, I've taken home the Heisman Trophy for myself, and that wasn't the only one I'd get as I also won the Maxwell, the Walter Camp, and the O'Brien, but it's because I threw for over 4,700 yards with 35 touchdowns to 6 picks, and then on the rushing side of things, I also had 16 touchdowns, so I guess I never realized how incredible of a season I really had, and I gotta point out our kicker Jordan Rogers, who has been perfect for the past 2 seasons. Now, even though we took down Northern Illinois, we still didn't crack the top 25, but we did receive some votes, and that's landed us versus Appalachian State in our bowl game. From here, I am gonna take the deep ball upgrade just to improve my throw accuracy, and I'm ready to finish my junior year. We are playing in the Independence Bowl versus Appalachian State, where I've already had to break 1 sack, and I'm just gonna go with the deep post over 2, Jay Stun II, who gets us inside the red zone. So a 59-yard reception is one of the best ways that we could have opened this game up, and Calvin Gibbs is going to take the halfback screen in. Even though he's our running back, he had a much better season when it came to receiving the ball. But Appalachian State responded back, so we are in a tie game at 7-7, and we need more points. I'm still super shocked at how well this season went. I can't believe I won the Heisman Trophy. I'm going to take the sack, though. And I've not been playing as well recently because I've been wanting to go with more of the deep routes. But that led to our second drive stalling out, and we need to figure things out on this third one where they just boxed up Malachi Harris. It was a pretty tight first quarter, so I'm hoping that we can pull away here in the second, and I'm just going to take our flat to Malachi Harris, which actually worked. I guess that's a sign that I should do that more often, and all we have to do next year is win a national championship because we completed the Heisman goal. But I have a feeling that's going to be pretty tricky to do with Northern Kentucky, especially if we lose any of our receivers. I think most of them are like 80 overalls, but you never know who could get drafted. And I can't view the depth chart, but I can see that Jay Stun II's a 91. I don't understand how he's progressed like 15 or 20 overalls in the span of just 2 seasons. But apparently that was third down and they held us, then scored a touchdown. So all of a sudden we find ourselves down by 7 points. And I don't know why I thought we'd cruise to an easy bowl win over Appalachian State, but I was loving those 4 verticals play calls from my head coach, and Calvin Gibbs is going to catch this one for a few. We're getting pretty close to tying things up, but I always hate making reads down inside the red zone. I did the right thing there, but it's only because Daylon Maurice was able to get open and this halfback screen just went backwards. Because it's not a home game, I can't put hot routes out there on the field, which really hurts us. And that's the next level of coach trust, which I can unlock, which we'll worry about next year. Until then, I just scrambled to get us the easy touchdown. And that was the perfect ending to the first half that we desperately needed. After this game, I have got to check how many times we've experienced a drop this season, so I just need to remember to do that. I am going to step up and run for the first here. But I also need to try and stand tall in the pocket more because our offensive line's better, and that is exactly why I don't do it. I have to make quick reads if I do. But those only get us a few yards, and on 3rd and 14, I think we're just going to hit Jay Stun II over the middle. Here we go. I'm starting to get into a little bit of a rhythm. I want to take him again, and he is going to reel it in. But we need about 0.5 yard more, and they have sent in a blitz, which means I'm just going to run for the touchdown. Since they'd only get a field goal out of their last drive, we are sitting with a 4-point lead. But once again, Daylon Maurice just can't hang on to the football, and the quarterback draw will not get free. This is a very big 3rd and 3 for us, so I'm just going to be safe, go to Calvin Gibbs. And I don't know why he'd step out of bounds there, but now it's probably going to be a 1-point game, and that's short. We honestly just got bailed out by the fact that their kicker does not have a strong leg, and there's nobody stepping up to me. So they should probably send more than one rusher in my direction, or they're just going to give me a lot of time. I'm pretty sure the last time we even lost in this video was against Ohio State, and that was a long time ago. So as of right now, we have got to be on like a 6 or 7 game winning streak. And because of all the fumbles I experienced in the MAC Conference Championship game, I am starting to slide. On 3rd and 4, I can tell that they want to dial in some pressure, but they're not going to stick with Jay Stun II. And after finding out that he's a 91 overall, it would honestly be huge if he returned to school for his senior season. I had so much time back there and I didn't make a read, but I'm going to step up. And with this run, I am in the end zone. My legs have gotten so much better as my career's progressed, but Appalachian State scored again. So we have to run out the rest of this clock, and that's going to be the first down. I'd honestly be so upset if we ended up losing this bowl game to them, but as long as we get a few more yards, we can seal our win. And it comes down to this 3rd and 4 where Calvin Gibbs is going to make it. It was a close call, but we have come out on top. But the real question will be how far this team can go next year, and we'll see if I can lead the Norse to a national championship. With some really hard out-of-conference games on the schedule, nothing will be a given, but I did just throw for almost 5,000 yards, so I should be able to lead this team, and I'm so excited to get into my senior year. But that's not going to come until next week, and after upgrading deep ball one final time, plus the off-season training results, my stats are incredible, and I will see you all next Friday when we find out how far the Norse are able to actually go.